Hello students, welcome to Dr. Deepa Dhake's NEET Biology. And in today's session, we are going to study about respiratory volume and respiratory capacities. In previous session from the same topic, we already completed about the transport of oxygen as well as the transport of carbon dioxide. Now when we study about the respiratory volumes and respiratory capacity, so at that time first we discuss about respiratory volume. For that, one thing you clear in mind, in 1 minute healthy person and the normal person breathe for 12 to 16 times, and whatever capacities and volumes we are studying, that basically volumes hum study kar rahe hain. So whatever kinds of volumes aap study karenge, all these volume we study for a single breathing or single inhalation and exhalation. If in exams question is asked for a 1 minute, so you simply multiply that volume by 12 to 16, so you can find out your answer. Secondly, stay connected with channel. The students who are new, they subscribe my channel and like my videos. Agar aapko content and material choice ka appear hota hai. Now we come towards the today's class or today's topic. First we study about respiratory volume. 4 types of volume students yahan pe basically. A conceptual part yahan pe clear kar lijiye. Normally whenever we breathe, 2 types of breathing we take. Either we undergoes normal respiration or normal breathing, but during the strenuous exercise or whenever we perform any of the heavy workout. So during heavy workout, you remember, the breathing is increases or the rate of breathing is increases. So at that time we inhale and exhale much more amount of oxygen and carbon dioxide. For this purpose we study the 4 different types of respiratory volumes. Tidal volume aap study karte hain. So first here when we study about respiratory volume, so first volume you remember, the first volume is tidal volume. When we study about a tidal volume, so here you remember the volume which can be inhale and exhale during the process of normal breathing. That means when we normally breathe without taking any extra efforts, at that time whatever amount of volume of air we inhale or exhale, that volume of air is called as tidal volume. So tidal volume means simply for objective purpose, you remember, normal respiration or during normal breathing, whatever amount of volume of inhale kar rahe hain. Secondly, the what is the exact value of tidal volume? So for a healthy and adult person, you remember, the tidal volume is 500 ml. 500 ml, this volume for per breathe, this part you remember. Now if we calculate this tidal volume for a 1 minute, so in 1 minute we are going to breathe for 12 to 16 times. So for 1 minute, the value of tidal volume is ranges in between 5000 to 6000. Or aap yaad rakhiye, the value ko aap simply under multiply kariyega by 12 to 16 times. When we multiply the value 12 to 16 times, so we obtain one value, that is 6000 to 8000 ml of air we can breathe per minute. So per minute when we breathe, so we inhale and exhale 6000 to 8000 ml, but in each breathe or in one inhalation 500 ml is a tidal volume. Now whatever air we breathe, क्या ये पूरा का पूरा एयर एल्वियोली तक आएगा? ये भी एक क्वेश्चन आता है कि सपोज वी इनहेल 500 ml ऑफ ऑक्सीजन और 500 ml ऑफ प्योर एयर अगर आप ब्रीथ कर रहे हैं, सो इफ दैट एंटायर एयर एंटर्स टुवर्ड्स द एल्वियोली और नॉट. सो ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर, ओनली स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ एयर और अ स्पेसिफिक आउट ऑफ 500 ml, अ स्पेसिफिक अमाउंट ऑफ एयर और ऑक्सीजन रीचेस टू द सर्फेस ऑफ एल्वियोली. सो हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ एयर, सो दिस यू रिमेम्बर, आउट ऑफ 500 ml, 350 ml ऑफ एयर रीचेस टू एल्वियोली and remaining 150 ml of air is present in conducting part. So you can go through the NCERT conducting part. What are the parts are included in this section? Conducting part mein that is clearly mentioned. So in trachea, primary bronchiole, secondary bronchiole, all they are comes under the conducting part. So in these tubes or in conducting part, 150 ml of air is always be remain to maintain the pressure gradient. So this part you remember for the tidal volume. Now we come towards the second volume that we study about the expiratory reserve volume. Here we study the volume according to the increasing order. So second increasing order means the value of the volume in increasing order we basically study. And after that when we completed these four types of volume, then I will give you clue that how you can recall or how can you recognize all the four volumes in increasing way. So tidal volume ke baad dekhe, yahan par aapka second hum study karte hain expiratory reserve volume. So expiratory reserve volume, NCERT mein expiratory reserve volume provided hai. Expiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume ka meaning hota hai ki do forcefully we undergoes in exhalation, kitna bhi forcefully, as much as forcefully you exhale the air or undergoes in exhalation, but even upon forceful exhalation the small amount of air is always be present inside the lungs. So whatever air forcefully we exhale, that volume of the air is called as expiratory reserve volume. So normal exhalation mein aap kitna exhale kar rahe ho, 500 ml we exhale, but under forceful exhalation we exhale the much more amount of air, that volume is called as expiratory reserve volume. Expiratory reserve volume means simply in one term you remember forceful exhalation, and during forceful exhalation you remember in one breath we exhale 1000 to 1100 ml of air, that is air which contain the carbon dioxide. So this part you remember for the expiratory reserve volume. Now we come towards the third kind of volume, that is the reserve volume. Reserve volume ka meaning kya hai ki ab aapne bahut forcefully exhalation kar liya hai, but even after that this condition never be happen that the air is completely absent or not present inside the alveoli and conducting part. Always there should be a some amount of air which is present or remain present inside the alveoli and conducting part. So for that you remember third volume we study, that third volume is called as reserve volume. Reserve volume means the volume of air which always present inside the alveoli as well as in conducting part. So reserve volume ko aap find out kab karenge, after forceful exhalation. So the value for reserve volume, you remember the value for reserve volume is ranges in between 1100 to 1200 ml. So forcefully aapne kitna bhi exhalation kari hai, even after that this much amount of air always be present in healthy persons. Now we come towards the fourth category. That fourth category is called as inspiratory reserve volume. That means the volume which can inhale by the healthy person during forceful inhalation. So whenever we forcefully inhale and forcefully exhale, so during forceful inhalation we inhale extra amount of air. How much extra amount of air we inhale? Because under normal inhalation hum inhale kar rahe hain 500 ml, but the volume which is to be IRB mein aap kitna inhale kar rahe hain, forcefully we inhale the 2500 ml to 3100 ml. So this is the value you remember, this is the value for IRV. So again one time you recall, tidal volume means normal respiration or normal breathing, expiratory reserve volume and inspiratory reserve volume means forcefully inhalation and forcefully exhalation. In forceful exhalation we exhale 1000 to 1100, then the even after forceful exhalation some amount of air always be present, so that is residual volume. Residual volume is 1100 to 1200 ml, and then after we come towards the inspiratory reserve volume, the volume which can inhale by forceful inhalation, that is 2500 to 3000 ml. Now what is the trick to recall all these volumes? You remember one term is there, simply aapko ek term yaad rakhna hai, that is TERI. TERI yaad rakhiye aap. Clear? And when you recall the TERI, so here you remember T for tidal volume, E for expiratory reserve volume, R for residual volume and I for inspiratory reserve volume. Now what is the value? T ke liye value yaad rakhiyega, increasing orders mein value yaad rakhne, 500 ml for tidal volume, expiratory reserve volume aap study kar rahe hain, expiratory reserve volume is 1000 ml to 1100 ml. ये आप याद रखिए. आफ्टर दैट यू कम टूवर्ड्स द रिजर्व वॉल्यूम. रिजर्व वॉल्यूम आपके पास है यहाँ 1100 से क्या आएगा, फ्रॉम 1100 टू 1200 ml इज द रिजर्व वॉल्यूम. एंड देन आई, दैट इज द इंस्पायरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम. सो हियर फॉर दिस यू रिमेम्बर द आई इज 2500 टू 3000 ml. सो दिस इन दिस वे इफ यू गो to recall the four kinds of respiratory volume, so it is quite easy for you. So simply you remember this term, and in this way you are going for recalling the different kinds of volume. Now we are come towards the respiratory capacities. On the basis of these four volume, one can find out the different capacities of the lungs, that how much amount of air one can inhale. So we find out the inhalation capacity, we can find out the exhalation capacity, vital capacity study kar rahe hain, total lungs capacity study kar rahe hain. So what are the formula? If you know the formula for all these capacities, so you can easily count the volumes which is to be inhaled or exhaled. So now we begins with the respiratory capacity. So students, now we study about the respiratory capacities. Respiratory capacities में different kinds of capacities आपको study करनी है. Basically these capacities are related with the capacity of the lungs, that how much amount of the air can be inhaled, can be remain inside the alveoli of lungs, or it can be exhaled by the lungs. So first capacity we study, that first capacity is called as inhalation से ही हम start कर रहे हैं. So first capacity is called as inspiratory capacity. So first when we begins with inspiratory capacity, it is commonly called as IC. And secondly देखिए, inspiration आप कर सकते हैं, we go for a inspiration in two ways, normal inhalation as well as a forceful inhalation. Therefore inspiratory capacity, whenever we study, inspiratory capacity is the equivalent to the tidal volume plus inspiratory reserve volume. So this part you remember, the tidal volume plus inspiratory reserve volume combined, okay, formation kiska karta hai, inspiratory capacity. Now what is the volume? Tidal volume dekhiye, tidal volume is 500 and inspiratory capacity ka agar aap appear kar rahe hain to kitna hai, 2500 to 3000 ml. So tidal volume, you see tidal volume is 500 ml and inspiratory capacity आपका कितना है, इंस्पायरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम, सॉरी इंस्पायरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम इज 2500 टू 3000 ml. सो टोटल इंस्पायरेटरी कैपेसिटी इफ यू फाइंड, सो इट रेंजेस इन बिटवीन 3000 टू 3500 ml. इट इज अगेन फॉर अ वन ब्रीथ और फॉर अ वन साइकिल ऑफ इनहेलेशन एंड एक्सहेलेशन. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन ओनली वन एग्जाम्पल आई एक्सप्लेन हियर, in what way you can find out the values of different kinds of capacity. So inspiratory capacity yaad rakhiye. Now we come towards after inhalation, we come towards the exhalation. So second capacity we study, that we study about the expiratory capacity. So expiratory capacity ke taraf jab hum aa rahe hain, so second capacity ka meaning hai ki what is the total capacity of exhalation for any of the lungs or respiratory system. So again expiratory capacity aap yaad rakhiye, it is again is sum of tidal volume plus ERV. Now tidal volume, again you see tidal volume is 500 ml and ERV agar aap appear kar rahe hain, So ERB is 1000 ml to 1100 ml. So 1000 ml to 1100 ml is the capacity for expiratory reserve volume. So the total exhalation capacity or expiratory capacity, aap keh rahe, it ranges in between 1500 ml to 1600 ml. This is not the negative sign. This is the range in between 1500 to 1600 expiratory volume is ranges. Now the third capacity becomes, that third capacity is called as functional residual capacity. Functional residual capacity ka meaning fir wahi hai ki upon what is the capacity of lungs to hold maximum amount of air even after forceful exhalation. So FRC, you remember the functional residual capacity. Functional residual capacity, students, you remember it is sum of expiratory reserve volume plus reserve volume. So this part you remember, FRC ka meaning kya hua aapka, expiratory reserve volume. Expiratory reserve volume jab aap study karte hai, so how much expiratory reserve volume we are having, 1000 to 1100, and RV, RV ki value kya hai, 1100 to 1200. So again you sum up both the ranges, so it ranges in between 1200, 2100 ml to आपका आएगा यहाँ पर ये 2300 ml. So in this way you remember the functional residual capacity of the lungs is the sum of expiratory reserve volume and IRV. Now we come towards the vital capacity. Vital capacity का meaning है कि lungs की total capacity जब आप study कर रहे हैं, so the capacity of lungs to inhale the air in normal respiration, that is tidal volume. The capacity of the lungs to inhale extra amount of air, that is IRB, plus आप study करते हैं the amount of air to be exhaled by forcefully, that is ERV. So when we study about the fourth capacity of lungs, that is called as vital capacity. Vital capacity अगर आप study कर रहे हैं, in short it is called as VC. And vital capacity, you remember, it is equivalent to total of vital capacity, means simply you remember the total capacity of lungs to inhale and exhale. Total capacity means inhalation and exhalation under normal condition, as well as inhalation and exhalation under the forceful condition. So because of that, vital capacity ka sum aapka jo formula hoga wo kya hoga, ERV, that is forceful exhalation, tidal volume, normal exhalation or normal breathing, and IRV. IRV ka meaning kya hua aapka, forceful inhalation. So when these three volumes, when we combined or aap plus karte hain, then we find out the vital capacity. So vital capacity, ERV aapka, ab ye values aapko yaad hai, if you know these values, so for that I will ye aapko bataya hua hai ki you go through this way, so immediately you recall the things and you can find out the vital capacity. And now we come towards the last capacity of the lungs, that is called as total lungs capacity or TLC. So fifth, you remember, fifth is total lungs capacity LC. Total lungs capacity ka simplest formula yaad rakhiye. Total lungs capacity means whatever amount of air to be present inside the lungs, as well as the capacity of lungs to inhale and exhale. So entire type of volumes ko inhale karna, exhale karna, plus some of the volume remain always present as a residual volume. Wo jab aap study kar rahe hain, so we study about the total lungs capacity. For total lungs capacity, you simply remember one formula. The total lungs capacity is a sum of vital capacity plus residual volume. Now when you recall this vital capacity and residual volume, so sometime aapko ye three values diye hote hain, IRV, ERV and tidal volume, and the question is asking for the total lungs capacity. So what is vital capacity? Vital capacity kya hai? Vital capacity is a sum of ERV, TV plus IRV. So if these three values are provided and in question is asking for the total lungs capacity, so first you sum up all these capacities and find out the vital capacity, and then vital capacity को आपको किसके साथ plus करना है, residual volume. Residual volume means 1100 to 1200 ml. So in this way you can go through the different kinds of capacities of the lungs. Secondly, for your NEET upcoming exam, this is one of the most important topic. Entire chapter ही आपका important है, but among the different topics of the chapter, this is again important topic because questions में generally आपका the different capacities are provided. कि suppose the person is having the expiratory reserve volume, or expiratory reserve volume is this, tidal volume is this, and on the basis of that the question is asking for the different kinds of capacity. So one time you again revise all these capacities, remember the tally. If you remember the tally, so easily, because in the form of tally aap increasing order mein 5000, 1000 to 1100, 1100 to 1200, या एग्जैक्टली आपका मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी किसकी है अपने पास, इंस्पायरेटरी कैपेसिटी, दैट इज 2500 टू 3000 एमएल. एंड अगेन वन टाइम रिकॉल याद रखिएगा कि दो भी इनहेल टाइडल वॉल्यूम आप इनहेल कर रहे हैं 500 एमएल, बट आउट ऑफ दैट 500 एमएल अप टू द रेस्पायरेटरी मेम्ब्रेन और अप टू द सर्फेस ऑफ एल्वियोली ओनली 350 एमएल ऑफ एयर इज एंटर, एंड रेस्ट ऑफ 150 एमएल इज रिमेन प्रेजेंट इन साइड द कंडक्टिंग पार्ट. स्पाइरोमीटर जनरली हम यूज करते हैं फॉर फाइंडिंग द अमाउंट ऑफ दीज वॉल्यूम. सो स्पाइरोमीटर के थ्रू आप ओनली जो मूवमेंट में एयर प्रेजेंट होता है, द एयर विच इन्वॉल्व इन मूवमेंट, दैट अमाउंट ऑफ एयर वन कैन फाइंड आउट विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्पाइरोमीटर. सो दिस इज फॉर ऑल टूडेज सेशन. इन नेक्स्ट सेशन वी कम विद द न्यू टॉपिक फ्रॉम द सेम ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी क्लास 11. By that time stay connected with channel. Again, अभी तक अगर subscribe नहीं किया है तो channel को subscribe करिए, and up to the next session stay motivated and stay blessed.